Hi, welcome to Movie Review with Daniel, and today I'll be doing a movie review on Secret Society of Second Born Royals. Secret Society of Second Born Royals is a 2020 American action film in the superhero genre. The film, which was released on Disney Plus on the 25th of September 2020, is written by Alex Litvak and Andrew Green, and directed by Anna Mastro. Beware, this movie reviews contains criticisms and spoilers. It's sort of Marvel for preteens who don't like actual superheroes. The latest original offering from Disney Plus won't make anywhere near as many headlines as Hamilton or Mulan did when they landed on the service. My most common feelings while watching it was one of surprise that it even exists, presuming it must have been designed as a long pilot for a TV series that never went to order on Disney Channel and is now being shoveled off to the streaming service, because nothing about this inert dull project feels like a movie. It's a half idea, half utterly filmed, yet it's a kid movie, but kids are smarter in 2020 about their action entertainment, and putting this alongside all the Marvel movies on Disney Plus feels almost mean. Pete and Elizabeth Lee is charming enough as Sam, the second-born princess in the royal family in the kingdom of Ilari. If you are expecting some sort of Narnian-esque vision of fantasy reality, look elsewhere, because the vision here is pretty much superficial. It's a modern, slightly futuristic city, but world-building was literally never put on the whiteboard on the writer's room for this project. Sam goes to school at a place called Strathmore with other royal teens, and the opening act of the Secret Society of Second-born Royals is basically a teen dramedy, as the film introduced us to Sam's friends, Mike, played by Noah Lachman, and a vain, mean girl named Roxanne, played by Olivia Dable. Suddenly, Sam learns that she has an important destiny. It turns out that the second-born royals in the universe have superpowers, and so SSBR shifts to what is essentially a young X-Men riff, with Sam learning her powers under the tutelage of Professor James Morrow, played by Skylar Austin. Each student's power reveals itself through a series of training exercises, and Sam learns that she has super senses. Her fellow second-borns, who have apparently all hit ex-puberty at the same time, including Invisible Girl, Roxana, Power Stealing, Jenry, played by Isabella Blake Thomas, Persuasive Tumor, played by Niles Fitch, and Nature Controlling Mateo, played by Fallon Rakotovana. The Quints is trained to control their powers, just as the film's Magneto, a telekinetic inmate body, played by Greg Brick, escapes from his prison and comes outside the school. To say that Anna Mastro's film has a pacing problem would be a drastic understatement. The opening chapter is fine enough because it allows Lee to carry the teen drama, but everything grinds to a halt in the midsection with a lengthy, boring training sequence. Imagine if the first X-Men film was an hour of the characters learning their powers. It's not being the way that's inexplicable about than to suggest it will feel different in a pilot of a series than it does as the majority of a feature film. It's a film that just takes forever to get off the ground, running for an hour if anything approaching traditional superhero movie action happen, and even then it is clunky and poorly done. To say that I didn't care about what happened to anyone in the Secret Society of Second Born Royals would simply imply that anything happens in the film. It is the most bare-bones superhero movies I've ever seen, entirely unambitious in its world-building, characters, and structure. The only thing that salvaged it in any way is the relative charm of the cast. Lee developed into a star, and I could see some of the young actors doing the same, but that got to stop signing on to second-tier projects.
Thanks for watching today's review. Please feel free to hit the like and subscribe button, and leave your comments in the comment box below.